The Yale School of Music's concert season is right around the corner. The season kicks off September 15th with a performance of Stravinsky's Rite of Passage. And this morning, we're joined by Peter Unjin, the principal conductor, to learn more about the work's history and its importance. You were just, you know, we're kind of telling each other a little bit about what's going on here. This is the start of a wonderful season ahead. You've got many, many performances ahead, right?
Absolutely. There's 6 major concerts during the year from the Philharmonia, and then others as well. We do some new music at a certain point, and then my conducting fellow conducts a concert in Sprague Hall. All the major concerts take place in Wolsey Hall, which is one of the most glorious places on the East Coast, actually, let alone in New Haven.
Yeah. You guys have been working very hard.
Well, actually, they just arrived. Yeah. The students just arrived, so the first rehearsal will be on Monday. And, I mean, half of them are new.
I thought you were joking me, but you're not, really, are you?
No, I mean, they put it together very, very quickly, and they're incredibly talented students. They come from all over the world, you know, and they've got a lot of experience already. They're graduate students. So, I mean, many of them have been performing all over the world already, and when they come together, it's incredible to feel this energy of all the young people.
Stravinsky's Rite of Passage. Talk to me about Rite of Spring. Tell me a little bit about this one, because this has a lot of history ties to it.
Yeah, well, it's it was premiered in 1913. Stravinsky had gone to Paris, and with Diaghilev, there was a lot of new ballets being done at that time, and people were fascinated. Many people were fascinated by this modern style, and many people were resisting it. But nobody expected what was going to happen with Nijinsky, who was the choreographer. Well, the first thing that happens when the curtain comes up, the dancers are pounding with both feet on the ground with this kind of pagan rite of passage type of music and activity on, and nobody's seen anything like this before. People started shouting and they started throwing things, and it got so loud that they couldn't even hear the music, apparently. And the music is incredibly exciting, but it was a very famous evening because there was a riot in the concert hall, basically. And after that, Stravinsky decided, you know, this is a great ballet, of course it is, and it was acknowledged as such just a few years later. But as a concert piece, it has become something extraordinarily famous, partly because of that premiere and partly because it's just an incredible experience. I mean, it's not classical music. Mm-hmm. You know, it has elements that are so incredibly primitive. So it's more like just a dramatic theatrical experience.
You talked about the students who come with a lot of experience. They've been doing this, but you too have a lot of experience, been doing this for many years. Give us a little bit about your background.
Well, I was a violinist, and when I graduated from Juilliard in New York, I joined the Tokyo String Quartet, which was a very popular string quartet around this area because they had already been in residence since 1976 at Yale. So in 1981, I went from being a student at Juilliard to being a professor at Yale, which was pretty intimidating. And for 14 years, we traveled around the world and we had teaching here at Yale. And then I had an injury to my hand and I couldn't play. I really knew I couldn't play any longer on the stage. So I decided to take up my second love, which was conducting, which is now my first love. and so in the last 14 years, I've been music director of the Toronto Symphony, and I'm also music director of the Royal Scottish National Orchestra in Glasgow and Edinburgh, and I guest conduct all over the place. But I've remained involved at Yale, so this is the beginning of my 37th year at Yale School of Music.
Wow, amazing. Peter Unjin, thank you so much for sharing part of your morning with us, and we look forward to this whole season ahead. For more information, you can always go to our website, WTNH.com, go to the On Air tab, pull down the Good Morning Connecticut Weekend section.